Today, we'll take a look at how to do bulk import for products with multiple variants. A variant is an alternate version of a product. In this video, we'll use iPhone X as an example. This is the perfect example to begin with because the iPhone X have multiple variants such as color and storage size. So let's begin. To do a bulk import, head to the menu on the left and click on Products. At the top right-hand corner, click on the button Bulk Import Product. In the pop-up menu, click on the words Product Import Template to download the Excel file. This is what we'll be using to do our bulk import. While the Excel file contains 17 fields, not all of them is required. We'll go through each field and explain what is required for each of them. So let's go back to the example of an iPhone X. An iPhone X gives you the choice between 3 colors as well as 3 different sizes of storage space. So in total, there are 9 different variants to this product. Let's start filling up the file and feel free to pause at any time to read the description on each field. The first field is product handle. The purpose of the product handle is mainly for the import and export process. Having the same product handle will let the backend system know that all the variants that are being uploaded belongs to one product. This is a compulsory field, which means that you need to fill it in. Next is the SKU. SKU is a unique number or code that is usually assigned to an individual variant. Similar to product handle, this is a compulsory field. Category name refers to the category you wish to sort the variant into. If the entry you filled in is a new value, a category will be created based on that value. Product name, which is also a compulsory entry, is the default name that the product will assume, which in this case is the iPhone X. Variants that have the same product handle will share product name. This means that you just need to fill in the product name once and leave it blank for the following entry for every variant that shares the same product handle. Product description is the default description of the product. This is similar to the product name, where variants that share the same product handle will have the same product description. However, this field is optional, which means that you can leave it blank if it's not applicable. Product open pricing determines whether your pricing is fixed or flexible. This is a true or false value field, which, to put it simply, is either a yes or no. So if your product offers open pricing, key in true. If it doesn't, key in false. Variant name override is the name of the variant. If this is filled in, it will replace the product name, which is currently iPhone X. So let's fill this up. Similarly, variant description override will replace the current product description. Variant base price is the selling price of your product. This is a compulsory field, which means that you have to fill it in. Barcode raw is your barcode number. For variants with multiple barcode number, you can link them using a comma. Variant supplier is simply the name of the supplier, in this case, Apple. Supplier code is a unique code that identifies the supplier of the goods. Variant cost price is simply how much it costs to purchase the variant. This is different from the variant base price, which is the selling price of the product. Attribute name refers to the additional characteristic of a product. In this case, the color of the iPhone and the storage size. Attribute value refers to the value of the attribute that sets it aside from the other variants. Text type can be keyed in and applied to the variant. However, there must be an existing text type created on the backend system beforehand. If this is not applicable to you, you may leave it blank. Lastly is composite. Composite is a mixture of product that is sold in a bundle. This is a true or false value field. That means that if your product is a composite, indicate true in the cell. If it's not, indicate false. Now let's fill in the rest of the variants. Remember to keep the product handle identical. but label each variant with their own unique SKU. Also change any of the field that is unique to the variant. In this case, the variant name override. Variant based price. Barcode number. Cost price. Attribute name and attribute value. Finish up the rest of the variants and save the file. Once you're done, upload the file into the system. And that's it. So let's check on our product now. If we click into iPhone X, we can see that all 9 variants are listed. You can add images to each variant by clicking on the image button at the top of the menu and click to add image. If we were to check on our POS system, you can see that the product is ready and available for sales.